Hello and welcome back to Plant Layout. In pursuit of operational excellence, an InvestNI video tutorial. In this chapter, we'll examine why you should think about plant layout. Why should you think about it? Well, sometimes our workplace can grow up around us without much thought as to how it's organised. As we add processes and make others redundant, make space for storing raw materials, or create buffers against unexpected demand, we place things where it's convenient to do so. These places may be convenient, but they aren't necessarily efficient. Workers must perform more movement, travel further, and suffer discomfort when their workplace is poorly designed, cluttered, or otherwise inconvenient. This wastes time and effort, which reduces quality and productivity. It also raises the risk of accidents and injuries. These problems can often go unnoticed. You probably spend a lot of time working to improve individual processes, but you may not have applied the same rigour to improving the overall physical space of your workplace. Plant layout helps you to think about the big picture issues of how you use space. How do you know that you have plant layout issues in your facility? Ask yourself some questions. Are you experiencing bottlenecks, poor customer service, or late deliveries? Is your inventory in good shape while customer service is suffering? Think outside the box. Forget the walls, pipes, drains, and everything else. If you had a blank canvas, what would you do differently? Take a look around your facility, follow the process flow, and look out for the following. Are some machines heavily loaded while others remain idle for extended periods? Is there excessive handling by skilled workers? Do you have a lot of goods in temporary storage? Are there long material flow lines and rehandling? Are some products spoiling during handling? Are you experiencing supervision and control difficulties? Even if your facility's plant layout is generally good, you may be forced to reorganise. You might be introducing new products, experiencing changes in demand, introducing changes to your product designs, storing large amounts of work in progress, or moving premises. What does good layout look like? A good layout minimises handling time and effort, utilises floor space well, shortens the distance that materials travel, utilises labour more efficiently, adapts to changing conditions, and increases production and reduces costs. Perhaps more importantly, but less tangibly, good layout can bring a sense of unity and purpose to your staff. Their movements and activities will seem choreographed in pursuit of the same goal, fostering team spirit and boosting productivity. As we move through this tutorial series, there are 9 factors you should keep in mind. These are things that will shape your choice of layout. You can download this list from the link below this video. How you arrange your equipment will depend on the type of materials in your product. You must consider the size, shape, volume, weight, and chemical composition of your materials. Each characteristic will influence your manufacturing methods, storage, and handling processes. It's important to understand the machinery and tools in your plant. How big is each machine? What's its purpose? How many people operate it? How much space do they need? 2 or more workflows might share a piece of equipment. Make sure the layout allows easy access to it. Shared equipment poses challenges beyond layout. You must consider scheduling and handling issues as well. A process monument is a unit or piece of equipment that cannot be moved. The location of your process monuments, just like receiving and dispatch areas, will have a strong influence on the rest of your layout. Consider your workers' needs. Labour, supervisors, and auxiliary services will all need to work in safety. They should have enough light, receive plenty of ventilation, and work in a reasonable ambient temperature with no undue noise. You must organise their activities too. Are the people with the right qualifications in the right places, in the right numbers, at the right time? They'll need to get in touch with each other regularly, especially supervisors coordinating work between different parts of the workflow. Communication equipment should be placed at regular intervals throughout the layout. Material handling doesn't add value to your product. It's a form of waste. Your objective is to minimize material handling by combining it with other operations and eliminating unnecessary and costly movements. The routes that materials take through the layout should be clearly marked. The flow of materials should be channeled by the layout to reduce the distance that products must travel. Consider the bulk of the materials that you're handling on the line. Make sure that lines dealing with the heaviest materials are close to entry and exit points. The location of your receiving and dispatch areas will exert a strong influence on your layout designs. If you're designing a space from scratch, give plenty of thought to those areas to minimise material handling. Restrict access to dangerous processes to authorised operators. Clearly mark the fire access points. Pathways should be clearly defined and free from obstructions. All machines and equipment should be easily accessible for cleaning and maintenance. You should aim to achieve continuous material flow through your facility to avoid the cost of waiting time and the problems that occur when the flow stops. Typically, auxiliary services such as stores, restrooms, and break areas represent around 30% of the space at a facility. Auxiliary services include spaces for the workforce, such as accessibility paths, fire protection installations, supervision areas, and safety equipment. Materials such as stores and quality control areas, machinery such as maintenance areas, tools and jigs, electrical and water lines. Building height is a major constraining factor. Make sure that you can fit machinery beneath the roof and that any heavy equipment is placed on floors that are rated for the load. Good plant layout is flexible. You need to be able to react to market fluctuations with minimum disruption to production. You can achieve flexibility by keeping the original layout as free as possible with a minimum of fixed centres. Some in-process tasks such as plating, anodizing or heat treatment might be contracted to outside suppliers. This can add to your layout's complexity, so you may have to treat the outsourced part of your operations as a separate workflow. That concludes this chapter in this video tutorial on plant layout. Join me in the next chapter, where we'll look at three common types of layout and the advantages each offers for different kinds of manufacturing. See you there.